Law and Order Facts Mars, and this is chess battle number two. I'm going to start the game. Pawn to queen four. Now look at this move by the computer. I don't understand that. You don't put knight. Actually, standard is knight to king bishop three. You don't put that knight over on the side like that unless you have a real reason to, which it doesn't. And yet, it's a tough player. I'm getting some kind of screen flicker. So I think it'll be brave and... Well, look at that. It's putting light back where it came from. So it's just wasted two moves. Well, I'm not going to waste any time. I'm going to get my pieces developed as fast as I can. Now, what it's doing is it's going to fianchetto its bishop. I don't know exactly what that word means, but in chess terms it means it puts the bishop on knight two, and it becomes it stares across that diagonal. Well, it didn't fianchetto it. How do you like that? Now you see, my pieces are getting all nice and developed, and all it has to show for its troubles is two pawns. And yet it's a tough son of a bitch once it gets going. So I'm going to go ahead and castle and get that out of the way. Now, it's putting pressure on that queen pawn. I don't have to worry too much about that right yet. So, I'm going to go ahead and continue. That's not what I want. Go ahead and put that knight up there. Now it's finally decided to develop its knight. I don't know what that screen flicker is. Sorry about that. It's very distracting. So I'm gonna give it a little calling card and put that bishop on that knight. I don't intend to take it. Unless it gets too obstreperous, in which case I just might. And I don't want him hanging around there, so he's probably trying to suppress my king bishop knight, my king knight from going up to my king five and putting pressure on that pawn, so I don't want him hanging around there, and this is all justification I need to do that. And well. So now it's just wasted another move. And if I could disrupt its pawns by taking the knight and my bishop, I might, but since I can't, that knight is backed up with the bishop, which is always a good thing to do. So, I believe Just for grins, I'm gonna set up right down there. Now, look what it did. It put the king rook over bishop one. That move sucks. I think it's missing out on the whole spirit of this thing, to be honest with you. So, here's what we're going to do. Put my queen there. Dangerous move on my part. Well, wait a second, this is a dangerous move on my part. I did not probably the brightest thing I've ever done, but we'll go ahead and move this rook over to guard that pawn. On second thought, still doing that. I think we'll just pick off at night. I saw something I didn't like, and that's all justification I needed. So, watch this. It's not going to be happy. It is not going to be happy with me at all. So now it's backed up that pawn with its bishop. That's not what I was hoping it would do, but that's life. Well, I got a number of problems here. I really hate that knight, and I will cram something right down its throat. It's really late, and I'm tired, so I'm going to pull a stunt, which will probably get me cremated, but oh well. That's the name of the game. So I am a couple of pawns behind. That's not good. Like I said, this thing starts out slow and it just gets mean. No other way to put it. So why don't we go ahead and neutralize that knight? Yeah, I'm not much of a threat there, so. What we can do is we'll take the rook here and put it on that king pawn. And try to keep pressure on the king pawn as much as possible. Alright, so I was driving my bishop back, and it didn't trade. So now his bishop is pinned. And what it's trying to lure me into doing is it's trying to lure me into moving my queen to king bishop 5, whereupon it forks my king, my queen and rook with its pawn. With this king pawn, that's not gonna happen. I'm well aware of what it's trying to do, so right, we just call its bluff and do this. Remember that bishop is pinned, so we can't. It's brave. Now the bishop, this is called an assumed pin. Which is different from an actual pin because an assumed pin, it can still move. So, I don't want to just give it my rook. That wouldn't be very good. So, I'm going to have to protect it. I think what we'll do is we'll take another rook and back it up. And it's not taking no for an answer there. It don't want that rook sitting there. And it don't matter what I want, apparently. I don't know why I did that. I'll probably get hammered, but I just cannot resist. So I went and grabbed that pawn. And despite what I want to do, I can't exactly do what I want to do. So put its rook there. I'll move my queen in. And of course it counters with its queen. One thing about it is these computers will figure out what you're up to after a while, and they will adapt. I must have had a way to offer to draw. I might just offer to draw, but they aren't built in with that function usually. So again, that move is not going to work for it. As well as just did, we're going to play bishop takes pawn. Remember, its bishop is pinned. It's not going anywhere. So I can safely take that with my bishop. I don't know, it's brave. There's no other way to put it, really. I smell blood, so I'm not, in the mood to withdraw or, anything like that. I smell blood and I'm going right after it. So what we're going to do, we go over here with the queen and check. And then it withdraws its king back. The bishop is still pinned. He's not going nowhere. And this is a dangerous situation for it because I could, in theory, pin its queen against its king, but it's got too much firepower there. So, and since my bishop is under assault, I think what we'll do for now is simply withdraw him to a safer location. Kind of lets that queen in a little bit, but I think under the circumstances it's worth it to me because I don't want him hanging around. And I move my king over to protect King 1. And also as a prelude to invasion, so to speak. Now notice that bishop is no longer pinned, at least not technically. So you're in a dangerous spot there, where he could, in theory, move if he wanted to. Of course, it might not be healthy, but he could. And there you go. Shove that pawn and my queen. So it's attempting a pawn incursion on that side. I'm certainly not going to encourage it. Right now, I don't have any decent access. Really, so we're gonna move. Yeah, this is what I was afraid of. So it's crammed that pawn right down my throat. But it's got a problem here. The problem is that its king row is now vulnerable to my queen, and it just ran over there. That's not healthy. It's not healthy at all. So we're gonna go ahead and check its king. And that did nothing. Alright. Well, we're about even here on this game. So, I have to put a damper on what it's doing over there on my king side, 'cause that's not looking good. I think we'll just go ahead and trade queens, get that bitch off the board, and then I think that we can start attacking pawns. Fairly well. So, we're gonna go ahead. And now we're getting down to the nitty-gritty. We're in an end-game scenario where I've got to be extra careful. This thing, I have played this before in end-game, and it is a good end-game player. Notice my king is on the white squares. What you're seeing here with the two pawns, that's called the Meroxi bind. And it just is a tremendously powerful control over that one square, and so it's not going to basically do anything, I don't believe. So we're gonna go ahead and once again we're gonna pin that bishop. He was pinned before, and then he got loose. Now, what it's trying to do is it's trying to draw me. It's going to show that pawn, try to trick me into losing my bishop. not gonna work. So here's what we're gonna do instead. In the process, I'm unpinning its bishop, but its supply of pawns is dwindling fast. And this is not going very well for it at this point. I'm not at all surprised that it did that, by the way. Now, I'm not going to get that bishop, and forget about that, but I can get the pawn, I believe. Well, probably not going to get the pawn either. At least not like that. And since my rook is under attack, I'm going to have to put him up here to defend the other rook. And that just fucked me over. This is what I said, this thing is a tough player when it wants to be. Well, unfortunately, it did manage to trap my bishop as well. But it's got a problem. Like, if it takes it, that rook ain't going nowhere. And I certainly see what it's doing. So, it's going to come down and check me with its rook. It's all the rook is going to try to checkmate me. And end the game that way. Other thing computers don't do is they don't resign. This is what I mean. This thing's a tricky devil. And there's no two ways about it. Yeah, it just makes me want to cry because I should have done better than this, but like I said, the thing is a really good in-game player. It's late, I'm tired. You can judge for yourself the mistakes I've made. Okay, I double dog dare you. It's going to get that pawn no matter what. So why not make it chase it? This game ain't over, folks. So what I want to do. And took the other one instead. And that is a draw. So there you have it. This game turned out to be a draw. Even though it has a rook and I don't. We moved back and forth, back and forth, and back and forth, and computer declared a draw. So that's the end of that. And matter of fact, Samara, thanks for watching.